Thank you. Good afternoon. Kamusta kayo to my Filipino friends. And welcome to the wedding of my niece Samantha and her beloved JR. For those of you who don't know me, I am Uncle David. I am married to Sherry, who is Samantha's father's sister. When we were younger, Sherry and Patty took turns having children. First, there was Justin, then we had Daniel, then came Andrew, then our Brian, then Bruce, then we had Brooke, and finally, Samantha. When Samantha was born, we were thrilled that our daughter, Brooke, would have a first cousin for her to play with because up until that point, it had been all boys. Sherry and I met in high school in the 10th grade, and as soon as I saw her, I knew I was done. But she wouldn't date me until 12th grade. Took me 2 whole years to convince her of what I knew, that we were meant to be together. We've now been married for 34 years. I started dating her, I was 15. We have 3 wonderful children, 2 granddaughters, and a grandson on the way. We've gone through tough times, joyous occasions, and all the best life has to offer together. Some words of advice for the happy couple. Be loving, be kind, be understanding, be giving, be caring, forgiving, and be loyal, but most importantly, be yourselves. A great marriage is when each partner supports one another through good times and bad. They build each other up and become each other's rock. When we first met JR, we knew right away that he was the right man for Samantha. He was very attentive to her and respectful, and we have never seen her happier than when she was with him. They seem to share so many of the same interests, physical fitness, both studying clinical psychology, so they can figure out why they like working out so much. It takes a very special person to go into clinical psychology and want to help others. And these are 2 such special people. Today, they are here to pledge their love to each other in front of all of us. As many of you may know, they met at school while both obtaining doctorates in clinical psychology. They grew close because they were both involved in the suicide and violence prevention organization. They did many community events, raising money and awareness, and provided education to the members of the community and other college students on these subjects, and even collaborating on journal articles for their newsletter. After Craig passed, JR was very supportive and even came to the Shiva to lend support. Now, I'd like to take a minute to talk about the bizarrely interesting coincidences between these 2 families. If you don't know, we have Sam on this side, but then we have JR, who's also a Sam. His father's a Sam, and believe it or not, his sister is a Sam. And then that's really like Sam I am. Also, each of them has a brother, Andrew. JR's family has 3 boys, JR, Kurt, and Andrew. And then the girl is the youngest, Samantha. Then on Sam's side, we have Justin, Andrew, and Bruce. And Samantha's the youngest there as well. Both families are also extremely close with their siblings and parents. On this beautiful day, we have the coming together of 2 families and 2 distinct cultures with several similarities. On the Jewish side, we have a dance called the Hora, and on the Filipino side, we have the Money Dance, which are both part of traditional wedding ceremonies that engage the audience. The Money Dance is similar to the Jewish tradition of giving gelt or money. When someone gets a new car or a new house, you give them money for good luck. These 2 have already started combining their cultures in their everyday lives. They would celebrate the Jewish holidays at Patty and Evan's home, where JR would always be inquisitive and ask questions about the Jewish tradition and Jewish faith. Samantha would celebrate Christmas with JR and his family. So now, as you can see, we're standing under a chuppah. Not exactly under, because the photographer said, can't get us. So I'm out in front, and so are they. This is the wedding canopy. It represents God's shelter and presence in the lives of the couple, as well as the new home they will be building together. The presence of family members, including the best men, Kurt and Andrew, the maid of honor, Brooke, and matron of honor, Andrea, under the chuppah, sort of, as well as its lack of walls, signify that family and friends will always be welcome in the couple's home. JR and Samantha wanted me to mention the loved ones who unfortunately cannot be here today and are missed greatly. Those include JR's grandparents, Enrique and Lodelina Cordero, and Tito Boyette, and on Samantha's side, Grandma Joan, Grandpa Jerry, Grandpa Bob, and of course, Craig, Samantha's father. Unfortunately, JR and Craig never got to meet, but Samantha knows he would have loved to talk to JR all about his culture and discuss the military with him. So let's have a moment of silence to remember these loved ones, please. Now, it is time for the exchanging of the vows. JR, would you like to go first? Okay. Sure. Or I can move it.
Okay. Check. 1, 2, 3. Good evening, everyone. Samantha Vance, you are my fire, my passion, my lantern in the dark. You are my everything, and most importantly, my soulmate. You've challenged me in ways I've never experienced before. You've redefined adventure, thrill, passion, and headaches altogether. You are unknowingly the co-author to my eternity. You are the flashlight to my dreams, especially when it gets dark. I love that you keep me grounded, yet encourage me to keep on dreaming. When I received the chance to grasp my dreams, I thought it was out of reach. You supported my trial and errors to make me strengthen to be the man I promised myself. I can't thank you enough. Now, I promise you I will love, care, and tend to our fire every day. I promise you my passion for our adventures, thrill, and life together will not burn out. Together, no darkness is a match to our eternal flames. Forevermore, through thick and thin, sickness and health, I will always be by your side each step of the way. Samantha Vance, I love you with all my heart. I will never stop. Is that good?
It was very poetic. JR, I did not know a love like this could exist until I fell in love with you. It's truly impossible to put into words what you mean to me. When I think of you and us, I think of home. I think of how safe and secure you make me feel, not only in our relationship, but everyday life. I'm so lucky to have spent the last 4 years learning, growing, and adventuring with you. I can't wait for a lifetime of doing this together. I admire the way you continue to show up for me and never leave me questioning your love. I even still have the message where you made me promise to marry you after only 2 months of dating. You're everything I've ever wanted and needed in a partner. I love who I am and who I've become because of you. As your wife, I promise to love you with the same devotion and confidence you've given me. I vow to always appreciate and notice the little and big things you do for us. I vow to always support you and with your ambitions and goals, even when they seem unreachable. I vow to help you slow down when you know you should, but don't want to. And lastly, I vow to never give up on us as we endure the adventures and inevitable challenges of life, but rather embrace them together.
Beautiful. May we have the rings, please? JR, you'll place on Samantha first. Okay. Place it on Samantha's finger and repeat after me, JR. It's a little Hebrew. Ani.
Ani.
Lidodi.
Lidodi.
Vidodi.
Vidodi.
Li.
Li.
I am to my beloved.
I am to my beloved.
And my beloved is to me.
And my beloved is to me.
This ring is symbolic.
This ring is symbolic.
Of my never-ending commitment.
Of my never-ending commitment.
Love. Love. And devotion to you.
Love and devotion to you.
Yes. Now, Samantha, you put the ring on JR.
Finally.
Got him now.
He's stuck.
And repeat after me. Ani lidodi vidodi li.
Ani vidodi. Lidodi. Lidodi.
Vidodi.
Vidodi.
Li.
Li.
I am to my beloved.
I am to my beloved.
And my beloved is to me.
And my beloved is to me.
This ring is symbolic.
This ring is symbolic.
Of my never-ending commitment.
Of my never-ending commitment.
Love and devotion to you.
Love and devotion to you.
Perfect. Now, JR, do you take Samantha to be your wife?
I do.
And Samantha, do you take JR to be your husband?
I do.
You may now kiss the bride. Now we are going to be, it is a Filipino culture to light the unity candle. The two separate candles symbolize your separate lives coming together on this day. Also, your families, your friends are all separate until today. Today we use those separate candles to light the unity candle, signifying how the separate sets of friends and families are now all one. When you get lemons, you make lemonade. All right. Now. Now I'm going to do the kiddush on the wine. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei pri hagafen. Take a drink. And JR, take a sip. And I'll another prayer on the chasen and kala, as they're called, the husband and wife. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher bara sason v'simcha, chatan v'kala, gila rina ditza v'chedva, ahava v'achava v'shalom v'reyut. Mehera Adonai Eloheinu Yishma Biara Yehuda Uvechutzot Yerushalayim Kol Sason Vekol Simcha Kol Chatan Vekol Chala Kol Mitalot Chatanim Mechupatam Unearim Memishte Niginatam Baruch Atah Adonai Mesameach Chatan Im Hakala. Blessed are you, Lord our God, ruler of the universe, who creates happiness and joy, groom and bride, exultation, delight, amusement, and pleasure, love and brotherhood, peace and friendship. Soon, Lord our God, may the sound of happiness and the sound of joy and the voice of the groom and the voice of the bride be heard in the cities of Judah and the streets of Jerusalem. The rejoicing of groom from their chuppahs and youths from their singing banquets. Blessed are you, Lord, who makes the groom rejoice with the bride. And now, to end it, it is customary for one to break a glass. There are many interpretations of this ritual. Some consider it a reminder of the destruction of the temple in Jerusalem in the first century. For even at the height of personal joy, we must not forget the tragedies the Jewish and world communities have endured. Others explain that the fragile glass reminds us of the delicate nature of marriage, which must always be cared for and cherished. So, yeah, under the
hook. Mazel tov, mazel tov.
Mr. and Mrs. Sam Soria.
Welcome in our parents this evening. Please welcome Patty and Evan. Come on. Let's welcome in JR's parents, Rose and Samuel.
With OG at a Yankee game. That made the Yankee hat more famous than a Yankee king. You should know I bleed blue, but I ain't a crypto. But I got a gangin' walking with my click though. Welcome to
and
the
of course, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome in more.
Home of the hip-hop, yellow cap, gypsy cap, dollar cap, holla back. For foreigners, it ain't fair, they act like they forgot how to act. 8 million stories out there in the naked city. It's a pity half of y'all won't make it. Me, I got a plug, special when I got it made. If Jesus paying LeBron, I'm paying Dwayne. Yes.
Yeah, it's time to welcome in our ladies, our bridesmaids this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, hands together and welcome your bridesmaids. Come on.
This is how we do
it. Let's go. Ain't no party without the gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, hands together. Welcome your groomsmen. Of course, that's your bridal party. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I want to feel that energy extra high. Because it's about that time to welcome in your newlyweds this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, hands together and make some noise for Samantha and JR, Mr. and Mrs. Soria. It's a little too quiet. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Mr. and Mrs. Soria. So, JR, my man, at this time, please grab that beautiful wife of yours. Hit that center of the dance floor, because it's time to share your first dance as Mr. and Mrs.
There goes my heart beating, because you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. please come back now.
There goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now.
I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean
just to be with you and fix what I've broken.
Oh, 'cause I need you to see that you are the reason.
My head shaking, and you are the reason. My heart keeps bleeding. I need you now.
If I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure the light defeated the dark. I'd spend every
once again, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you your newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Soria. So, JR, my man, I don't want you to go too far. I want to invite your beautiful mother, Rose, to join you on the center of the dance floor to share a special song this evening.
Backs on you, and you're so helpless, you don't know what to do. I'll be on your side to comfort you. My love will see you.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, how about a nice big round of applause for JR and his beautiful mother Rose this evening? So, ladies and gentlemen, like I said at the start, we came to party and celebrate. No Jewish celebration could kick off without a traditional Torah. To the dance floor, to the dance floor, to the dance floor. Come on, come on, come on.
Hava, Nagila, Hava, Nagila, Hava, Nagila, Nevesh Machad. Hava, Nerunana, Hava, Nerunana, Hava, Nerunana, Nevesh Machad. Hava, Nerunana, Hava, Nerunana, Hava, Nerunana.
There we go, there we go.
Salinu
Atalinu, Atalinu. Atalinu, Atalinu, Atalinu.
Come on, come on.
Havacharashnu v'gam zaranu. Havacharashnu v'gam zaranu.
That's right.
Atalinu, Atalinu, Atalinu.
And ladies and gentlemen, nice and loud, if you came to party with Mr. and Mrs. Soria, make some noise. It's about that time.
Let's
to get this party started on a Saturday night.
Come on now.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haoret.
There we go. Nice little round of applause for Grandpa Fred this evening. Nicely done.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Evan, Sam's stepdad. Patty, mom.
Hi, how are you?
Got to get my glasses on for this. It's a little different talking about your daughter than it is standing in front of a bunch of people talking about poor clients or something like that. But anyway, thank you, everyone, for coming tonight. You being here shows how much you love Sam and JR, and we really appreciate that. We wanted to thank the Sorias for dinner last night. Thank you very much. That was really appreciated, very grateful. Taking care of business here first. Unfortunately, Grandpas Jerry and Bob are not with us, or Sam's dad Craig and JR's grandparents. We know they're all looking down on this very happy occasion. The mints on the table tonight are in memory of Craig Vance's company, Mint Marble. You'll see that they're there. And again, we wish they all could be here tonight. I was warned about the length of my speech by Sam a while ago. So listen, last time I get to do this, sit down, get comfortable. No, I'm kidding, all right? But actually, I have an attorney friend over there. Dan, tell me when I have 5 minutes left of my half hour, please. Just kidding. I met Sam almost, I guess it was 12 years ago, a little girl who was very shy, passive, and not particularly talkative. Boy, JR, has she changed. The first time I met Sam, Patty had brought her over to the house. As we walked around the house, Sam disappeared. I found her lying on the floor, hugging our very, very large Labradoodle, Cody. Some of you may know him. Yes, good old Cody. She was loving on the dog, and Cody seemed to really like it. I knew Sam was a good person because he was very intuitive, so I figured I'd give her a chance. I think more importantly, because Sam liked my dog, she was willing to give me a chance. But, you know, it's not easy for kids moving into a new home with a stepfather, especially an old-school stepfather like myself. They learned a few new dirty words living with me. The one that Sam really enjoyed, or really thought was horrendous, was chores. Being old school and having kids, I prided myself for 20 years never having to take out the garbage, empty a dishwasher, or set a table. Sam got to know what, well, her brothers at least, taking out the garbage was, bringing in the groceries, cleaning the tables, emptying the dishwashers, or the most dreaded one for her and Andrew, doing the outdoor weekend project. I mean, outdoors in the sun, poor Sam, getting her hands dirty. Nah, that wasn't happening. To be fair, being in a blended family was hardest on Sam as the youngest. She had to deal with it all. While the others eventually left the house, Sam had to deal with many of the chores and all of the personality disorders. Personalities, I didn't get that right again. No wonder she went into psychology. Anyway, when Patty and the kids moved in, I was blessed to get what we call my four bonus children. I had the pleasure of watching Sam grow into a really good teenager, excelling both academically and athletically on the softball field, all the while dealing with me and another one of my favorite words to kids, no. No, you have to do the chores before you go out, Sam. Remember that one? No, you can't stay out that late. You got a curfew. No, you're not walking out of the house in those shorts. No way. Or, I love this one. Freshman year, I'm going on a date. He's coming to pick me up. And the date comes over, a senior in high school, driving a car. And I said, no hell, you're not going out with that guy. One of the few times her brothers backed me up, by the way. To say the least, I wasn't number one on Sam's hit parade in high school. We had a very, very serious love-hate relationship. She hated me, I loved her, you know? I don't regret any of the arguments I had with her. I could sleep at night knowing I said my piece, and mainly because I knew Sam was smart enough to eventually know that it meant that I cared and loved her very much. She learned as a parent, and I'm hoping that JR also learns this in the future, that it's harder to say no than yes to your kids, but sometimes it has a lot more in raising them and turning out them to be the people they become. Sam followed her plan. She went to college on a softball scholarship, graduated UF, and now will get her psych doctorate degree this spring, all while finding the perfect man. Sam, I just want you to know in front of everybody here, I can't express how much I love you and how proud I am of you. JR. I wasn't real sure how I felt about him at first. Okay? Folks, I got to tell you something. He is just so damn nice and polite, I thought it was an act, okay? It took 3 years before I realized that's really who he is. I figured, listen, if he was that good an actor, he would have been in Hollywood and never came to South Florida, but anyway. JR is very much like Sam. He's extremely dedicated, intelligent, articulate, level-headed, loves the outdoors, and a great addition to our family. Okay, I ran over my time. JR, I will leave you with this marriage tip. Remember, in my home, I'm the boss. Patty is just the decision maker. We are delighted to celebrate this union and welcome the Sorias to our very complex family. So in honor of the newlyweds and uniting our families, I ask everyone to raise their glass and toast this beautiful couple. And of course, we left our glasses. So we will let you guys do it for us. Go ahead, clink it. L'chaim to life.
I definitely will be shorter than that. Thank you all for coming, first of all. David Lombardi, you knocked it out of the park. The officiator, thank you so much. All right, where do I begin? I can start by telling you all how smart, how beautiful, how compassionate, loving, and caring Sammy is. But we all already know that, so I won't tell you. Oh, this special day. I just want Sammy and JR to know how proud and happy her grandpa Bob and Jerry and her dad Craig are. Looking down from heaven, they are surely missed today. So I will just say, my dream came true when Sammy was born, my baby girl, after having three boys. My family was complete. Her brothers adored her and still do. From the time she was three, when I coached her in baseball, what a baller, to our trip to Disney, just us, family vacations, New York for my 40th birthday, going to the Yankees-Red Sox game. Yankees won, thank you very much. Her beauty shines from outside, but it stems from inside. She's the entire package. You got very lucky, JR. So fast forward, when she started dating JR and they got serious, I found out Air Force was on the table. I was sad about missing my daughter. But as everyone can see today, JR brings out the best in her. Their adventures are endless. Rogue is lucky to be part of their family. But more importantly, JR is a good man. He's smart, loving, and protective over Samantha. So I am confident they will have a happy life. What else could a mom ask for? Oh yes, they will both be referred to as doctor this June. So not so bad, my Sam, Mr. Sam and JR, doctors. May your love get stronger day after day. And a special shout out to my husband, Evan, for all his support during all of this. Congratulations to JR. And Sam, you better remain a Yankees fan. Again, thank you, everybody, and cheers to the new couple. L'chaim.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Nice round of applause for Patty this TV. Nicely done, my love. So at this time, we want to invite Mark to join us on over by the newlyweds.
How did I get here? 25 years ago, I got introduced to this woman named Patty, And we became really good friends. And from that point on, we started to spend some time together. I got to meet the children. We, you know, again, started to spend some time with the kids and, you know, the boys, Andrew, Bruce, and Justin. And then there was Samantha. This little three-year-old girl dressed in a leopard print shirt with black shorts with pigtails. She looked like Pebbles Flintstone. And from that point on, I think this thing went out. And from that on, hard. Some weeks later, my life changed. About 3 weeks into that, next thing you know, I got a car seat in my car. And I'm driving from Coral Springs to Plantation every day, switch my work schedule to pick her up from school. Wow. So what do? I did what any insane person would do. I married her mother. And that was it, insta-dad. Four kids. Definitely my life took a turn. But you know what? I traded in the gym. I traded in golf for baseball, softball, basketball, football, and lacrosse. And yes, that was the best decision I ever made. The love I received from all four of the children was nothing like I ever thought that I could ever have or deserve. Becoming a father was not biological to me. It was about being there unconditionally for somebody, loving them, providing, protecting, guiding them through life, and I am very blessed to have had that opportunity. Samantha, you have grown to become not only a beautiful woman, but you have a heart of gold. You are a strong, independent, intelligent woman. I remember one day, you were in the fourth grade, and she said to me, I want to ride my bike to school. And I said, no. She said, why? All my friends are doing it. I said, no, not happening. And eventually, you got with the program and understood that all I wanted to do was to protect you, and that was my job. There are so many other memories that I cherish all through my life. The traveling, softball. I don't think that there's a Walmart in the state of Florida that we haven't been in. But these are times that will be in my heart forever. I don't think that there's any amount of preparation that leaves you feeling ready to give your daughter away. But if I had to choose one person to hand her to, JR, it's you. Anytime, any day, you're the one I choose. A happy marriage, Sam and JR, begins when you marry the person you love, and it blossoms when you love the person you marry. To the bride and groom, I wish you health, happiness, and many adventures, of course, with Rogue. I wish you wisdom to approach life's challenges together, and remember that today is the first day of the rest of your life. I love you both.
Nice round of applause for Mark this TV. Nicely done. And to conclude our first half of our speeches, we do want to invite Samantha's brother, Justin, to join us on Over by the Newlyweds.
To quote the great Dwayne The Rock Johnson from my favorite song in a Disney movie, you're welcome. Because as 45 says, this is going to be one of the great speeches you'll hear in your life. I wasn't sure if I was going to give a speech. My sister worries about me making myself look inappropriate, or simply put, like an asshole. Because our father's no longer with us, who would have a much more magical and colorful way of speaking than I could, I wanted to speak on his and my brother's behalf. As Samantha's oldest brother, I always felt it was my duty to look out for her, then, now, and in the future. Even though she's getting married, she will always be the baby sister to me and my brothers. I don't know how proud you realize we are, and how proud Dad would be that you're the first of us to complete college and obtain multiple degrees from multiple schools, and we all know that having a psychology degree in our family can be very useful, given the characters we have in our family and have accumulated along the way. I know Dad is watching and smiling with adoration and pride, looking at you today on your wedding day, smiling. The four of us were his world, and I know that you felt the same way towards him, which is why you got the tattoo of Abba, the Hebrew word for dad, on your wrist. When I first saw that, tears streamed down my face because I saw the mutual love that existed. JR, I gotta tell you, you're lucky he's not here because he's one of those dads that would watch you like a hawk, reenact and personify his favorite mob movie characters with you and as you take on the responsibility to take care of his little girl. He'd like your military background and interesting cars. There is no doubt that he's watching from above and smiling with pride with six Long Island iced teas and hopefully sitting down. So cheers to Samantha and JR, and wish me luck on not pulling a repeat of Evan and my mom's wedding tonight.
How about a nice round of applause for Justin, ladies and gentlemen?
Hi, guys. I'm Andrea. I am Samantha's sister-in-law. You guys are so nice. Sam, where do I even begin? There is so much to say. First, I want to start off with how happy I am that you found your soulmate. There really is no greater feeling than finding your person. You two are magic together. Sam, I am so grateful for you and the friendship we've built. From the moment I met you, I knew you were my favorite Vance. Sorry, Bruce. I love you too, Andrew. You made me feel so welcomed into your family, and it felt like home to me. So I married your brother, and now you can never get rid of me. Youngest sibling to another, apart from being the best ones for my brothers and sisters, just kidding, but we know it's true, I just want to say how amazing it is to have you in my life. I truly admire how fearless you are and how adventurous you are. I love how we can lean on each other and learn from each other. I've always wanted a little sister, and now I finally have one. I also gained a brother, JR. I have so much fun with you every time the family gets together. I think you are smart. It's a little inside joke. I think you are so smart and so kind, but the best part is that you're perfect for Sam. You two bring out the best in each other. Always remember to love each other through the good and the bad, to always support each other, each other's dreams, and to always be ready for the next adventure. Most importantly, JR, always remember that Sam will always say yes to coffee ice cream with sprinkles after dinner. I love you both very much. I'm so excited to see what the future holds for you two. Thank you.
Me? Never. Hey, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Brooke, and as she is my cousin, Sam was my first friend. I was a year and a half old when Sam was born, and neither of us knew what we were in for as toddlers. As the youngest in our families with only older brothers, our moms thought they should dress us in frills, ruffles, velvet, animal print, bows, and lots of pink for as long as they could possibly get away with. It haunts us to this day. One thing that always bonded Sam and I was the experience of being the youngest girl with older brothers. Constant sports, wearing their clothes as hand-me-downs, always being surrounded by boys, the physical fighting masked as a game of mercy, the list goes on. But I'd like to consider those transformative years as character building. My brothers always told me they were preparing me for the future. And it's clear Sam's brothers felt the same way. Because of this, we're stronger, tougher, and more sure of ourselves. I've never seen Sam more sure about anything than her future with JR. With any potential obstacle thrown her way, she was always up for the challenge as long as it meant they were together. From the moment I started hearing about JR to them moving in together and becoming parents to Rogue, the road trip to Ohio for a year, and the unknown of their next move together, JR is Sam's constant. I know that wherever they go together is where Sam will consider home. Sam, we tell each other often how happy we are that we're not just cousins, we're best friends. Even though you're no longer living in South Florida, I feel closer to you than ever. I love our almost daily conversations about literally anything, especially the excitement we share with each other when it revolves around food or our dogs. I'll never forget going on Birthright with you, mainly because you had to wheel me through the airport where I almost got detained for having Kawasaki disease. Or the time we went to a Red Sox game and almost got kicked out for me sneaking you alcohol. But seriously, I feel so fortunate for all of our memories together, and being your maid of honor has been the biggest honor of all. JR, I couldn't imagine Sam finding anyone better suited for her, mainly because she found someone who's always down to drink tequila with me when she's not. You're always so thoughtful and respectful when it comes to Sam and everyone she surrounds herself with. I love seeing how you two are always going on bike trails, exploring new places, or at CrossFit together, pushing each other to be the best versions of yourselves. And please know, JR, going forward, that whenever her and I are having dinner, you're invited. If you didn't get the invite, that was on Sam. So cheers to a new Sam Soria, because a fourth one was needed. I wish you both a lifetime of love, happiness, endless adventures, and the best ice cream in town. I love you both.
Yeah, that's right, ladies and gentlemen. Keep it a round of applause going for our maid of honor, matron of honor, Brooke and Andrea this evening. Nicely done, ladies. Now, at this time, to conclude our speeches, I want to invite our co-best men, Kurt and Andrew, to join us on over by the newlyweds.
Hello, everybody. Glad everyone made it out. You'll have to excuse me. I'm a little nervous. My brother is definitely the better speaker of all of us siblings. Okay, definitely. So, first of all, Samantha, you look amazing tonight on your day. Jay, that'll do. So, us being siblings, there's four of us, and you know, the third Samantha in our family, she's somewhere over there, but we've always been so tight. There you go. Yes, sir. We've always been so tight as a family, so welcoming in another Samantha to our family is just so important to us because of how tight we are. We've always been very close to each other, but you know, as growing up, very competitive when it comes to video games, when it comes to sports, when it comes to CrossFit. But in the end, Jay, we found out who are the real best men here. Us two.
Right here. And he chose us too, so.
Yep. All right. Let me pull out my phone. What's that? Oh, no, I got lost. So, Jay, you know you've always been the kindest. Everyone here's already said it, and they've known you for some time in South Florida, or SoFlo. So, my brother has been taking care of people ever since we were young, taking care of our cousins, his friends, myself, my brother Andrew, our sister, everybody. So, I'm so glad that you two found each other. Now, Samantha, that goes on to you, taking care of my brother, Jay, taking care of Samantha. I'm looking forward to what you two can bring to the future and what you guys can do for each other, right? So, you two deserve the best in life and every single blessing coming your way. We want nothing but the best for you two. Everyone, please grab your drinks. Give a quick cheers to these two. To Samantha and Jay.
Cheers. That was good.
And my brother Andrew.
Dude, that was really good. Yeah, he didn't even read it. I'm like, I'm going to be on my phone the whole time. I've got a little bit longer than that. So, good evening, everyone. Thank you for being here. I'm Andrew, the oldest brother of Jay's oldest brother. I'm very happy for the newlyweds. Let's give him another round of applause, please. Everyone, thank you. There we go. All right. So, I must say that I'm very proud of the relationship the two of these guys have built. I believe it to be a very strong one. In a relative short time that you've been together, you guys have been through some crazy shit. I mean it. I mean, check it out. Let's see, there was you guys been together for 3 to 4 years now, four, I think, yeah? And going through school for your PhD program, that's not only difficult, but let's add a pandemic in the mix, right? So now they have to be quarantined with each other, stuck with each other at home. I don't know if Floridians actually did any quarantining, I'm not sure. But we'll talk about that another time. So a new relationship, they're stuck with each other. Crazy, and all of us, Jay's family, are all in California, across the country. So thank you to Samantha, you and your lovely family, for taking care of our brother. That was really nice. Now, one thing I will say about my brother is that he's a very resourceful person. He is, very resourceful. If you didn't know already, he will buy a perfectly working truck. He's got his second off-road truck now, is a Tacoma. Perfectly functioning truck. And he'll beat it to death, and then he'll upgrade parts to make it even better off-road. So yeah, very resourceful. He'll do all the work himself. And then, let's see, after that, I want to talk about the pandemic next. Keep in mind, he's very resourceful, right? So I often thought about my brother Jay, how it must be really difficult for him not having his family, his brothers, sister, parents with him in that tough time. You know, he's in Florida while we're across the country. Now, I don't know how it was here in Florida, but in California, there was a massive TP shortage. Toilet paper. People were flocking the stores. Wait, hold on. People were rushing the market, the groceries, emptying out the shelf. They're going to Costco, Sam's Club. All the TP's gone. It's crazy. So at this time, I would call my parents, my sister, my brother Kurt, checking up on them. Hey, are you guys good? You guys got toilet paper? Everything's good? Cool. Guess what? I never worried about my brother Jay. I did not fret about him running out of toilet paper or anything like that. He's resourceful. We had this trip in the Philippines some time ago. What was it, 2013? Something like that. What? Yeah. Something like that. Okay, so we're in the Philippines. We just finished having lunch. We're all going back to our van. It's very hot and humid over there. It's crazy. We're wearing like slippers and shorts and just t-shirts, right? So we're all waiting for him. He was the last to get back in the van. And we're pretty pissed. We're like, dude, what took you forever? And he's just smiling to himself. He sits down in the back of the van with the rest of us. He's spreading his legs real wide, big grin on his face. I'm like, what's going on, dude? It's too hot to be that happy. He goes, hey, guys, it's a little bit cooler over here, right? Don't you guys feel that breeze? And I go, what are you talking about? He's all, yeah, I'm free balling right now. I'm like, why are you free balling, dude? He goes, well, the stall I went to didn't have any toilet paper, so I had to make a split decision. It was either my socks or my underwear. He went with the underwear because he knew we would notice that he's missing his socks. So, yeah, that's pretty much, I'm like, I'm never going to have to worry about him in that regard, right? Now, before I wrap this up, all jokes aside, I want you guys to take this moment. Look. All these people that love you are here, right? Listen up. Look at each other. Please, do this for me, just one time. I want you guys to look at each other deeply in your each other's eyes. The person you love the most right here in front of you. Now, statistically speaking, you guys are going to murder each other. As psychologists, you guys know this, right? But, yeah, congratulations. I love you guys. I want to share a toast. Cheers, cheers. Gotcha, gotcha. Sorry. Thank you.
Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on a tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean. Sleep in peace when day is done, that's what I mean. And this old world is a new world and a bold world.
That concludes all our formalities. There's only one thing left to do. And that's party. The dance floor is open once again. And I don't want you guys to be shy in those seats because we could have gone to dinner anywhere. But tonight we came to party Soria style. Hit that dance floor. It's Saturday night. Come on.
Duro. ain't a thing. Club jumping like LeBron now. Bowl it, order me another round. Homie, we about to clown. Why? Cause it's about to go down.
Swing your partner round and round.